Alright. Hold on. I'll send you a screenshot. Of the team. Jack, are you here?
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Here's the longtime Bronco, Jason Elam, to get us started. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team.
Oh, switch that thing.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five.
We got three.
Now it's Jackson. Flushed out right. Got one on the right sideline. That's good. A 14-yard first-down pickup for the Jaguars.
In a glimpse of his athleticism, they're all with the tongue tackle.
He can use his legs to dance around back behind the line of scrimmage and beyond the line of scrimmage.
And when you love to get a copy of his defense's guy, to because he's been stressed the whole time. Keep him bottled up, keep him in the pocket. This is the first drive of the game, and emotions are running high. Someone forgot that, tried to make a big play, and gave up a bigger one instead.
11 yards there for Jacksonville.
And run it again, keep going.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory. At the 45-yard line. It's Jackson.
Oh, good strip.
The ball's out, and the Raiders pick it up. And here's a
super
way down inside the 35-yard line. So the defense there.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Not the freak made a big catch.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. The pickup goes for 16 and a Raider first down. Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. First and 10 at the 19. This is Henry.
That's
one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments and doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
To throw on second down, Cunningham steps away to his left. He's going to take off with it. After the run throw, the decision is good one, picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
Obviously, a big play was needed, and you can see his eyes light up as he realized there's absolutely no one in front of him. And he takes off and goes. It goes off the long way. Not only does he...
And he's over the line and in for a Raider touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out. As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. And that's why you have the fullback, Charles. Couldn't get it in the play before. The smaller guy turned a little more power. They score.
And that has to win the hearts of a lot of old school football fans. They love when they get to see a little bit of power football.
Following the touchdown, here's Eden to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they had the fumble last time that they led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. It's up to the offense to get out here and pick things up.
They're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it is going to be 15 yards.
Now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. And that is intercepted. Or was it? We could say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
It is tough to complete passes against zone defense. The windows that you see open, they shrink pretty rapidly. How about being able to hit a moving target against the zone before the next guy can get there and make a play on the ball?
Not easy for any quarterback, no matter the situation. And there, the defense won the battle. Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
They'll try and run for it. Surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And that will force a turnover on downs. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Derek Henry. And an out run. And they'll get him down after a pick.
swim here early on. It didn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy this caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. They'll run it here. This is his third down get in the carry. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, not a lot of flash and dash on that play. Second and two, they hand it to the big man, and he ends up picking up a first down. Pick a gray area there, though, but I think what they thought, hey, we hand it to him here. And he'll take it. Explosive run, and one thing I've learned about time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to walk well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, eh?
Oh, without a doubt, you need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Following the touchdown, here's Elam to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not going deep into their script. I think they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet. I'm trying to get some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
A great example right there for the loss of the tackle. Dancing to his left. And he's just taken in. It's complete. And he takes this one down all the way to the 30. A big pickup of 38. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. They run on first down with Jackson. They'll get the first down and move inside the 20. Touchdown. Jaguars. A great play there. 32 yards. As his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. And there you go, nothing to do, two complex. Block, keep to your assignments. Got to run it in, they get it.
From the middle football. Good blocking, gets good tackle on that play. End result, touchdown.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. This will be taken in at the one. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. To start the drive, they'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. That's on the right side with Henry. And he'll be taken down right around the 27. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to bring up a third and about 7 left.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits, and it increases like they're able to exploit right there.
Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the American hero, Pat Turner. And he's going to return it back to the 21-yard line.
Well, this was a 14-0 game not too long ago. Things were looking pretty good. And then you give up the touchdown on the last drive. Now the interception.
So that's a lesson in trying to stay vigilant, isn't it? You have to stay on top of things. Can't relax too much, because as you know, things change. Now we're going to go out there and get a spark going again and try to slow down this comeback.
That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down. Throwing on 7-13, Jackson, under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
stabber coming out of Rochester, New York, in for the sack. Needs something deep in the bag of tricks here. It's a first and second down. Went backwards. It's third and very long. And we'll get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown.
You got it. You got it.
A great effort there. He scored on the ground and through the air. As they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Right after, right down the middle. And we've got a tie game here in a back and forth first half. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This fielded at the two. Return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy because you want to make sure that the catch is secure. And a lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound off the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
That's great.
Looking to throw it on second down. Jackson eluding the pressure right. And hit Jackson for three. And down inside the 14, shy of the 10. A Jacksonville first down and pick up of 17. It's Jackson, and they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and that'll make it second and 12. Now it's Jackson. It's caught by Jackson. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's a gain of 5, and it'll be third down. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. A reminder coming up here at halftime. We'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman with our first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. Being chased out there. And they will score. It's a Jacksonville touchdown. Lamar Jackson with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Jaguars have taken the lead. Extra point right down the middle. The lead is now 21-14. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll take this across the 25. Extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Oakland offense about ready to start this next drive. They'll look for a drive to tie this up. Down 21-14 as they have it first and 10. Now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. CD, with that incompletion, let's talk AFC playoff picture. I think you and I agree that if you put together the sort of power rankings, we put Baltimore number one, certainly in the AFC. But you look ahead to the playoffs getting started on January 4th. Who do you see as the main competitor for that Lamar Hill trophy?
Well, tradition, and us not wanting to be wrong, dictates that we say New England next, and rightly so because of the number of Lombardi trophies they've won, how they've always played at this time of year. But the bottom line to me is the prime contenders right now for Baltimore, Kansas City, Patrick Mahomes is gathered together, the defense is playing better, and Buffalo really showed me something when they beat Pittsburgh in Pittsburgh on Sunday night in Week 15.
Here's Cunningham. Complete. The intended target, T.J. Hockenson, at second down. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
So second down, still 10 yards to go, on the 43. Now Cunningham.
Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jonathan Jones. Through an opening, and there he goes. And a score. It's a Jacksonville touchdown. To blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way.
Not that rage quit. Got that one.